expressed on the Edge are not necessarily those of this radio station, its staff, management, or other sponsors. It's time for the Edge Radio broadcast with your host, Daniel Ott. You can join Daniel and his guests as we discover the truth together. Within the continental U.S., call toll-free 1-800-996-9638 or click on the Past Blast link on the Edge Broadcast website. That's toll-free 1-800-996-9638 or click on the Past Blast link on the Edge Broadcast website. You can find out more about our guests and topics by logging onto the Edge's website at theedgeam.com. That's theedgeam.com. And now, here's your host for the Edge Radio broadcast. Here's Daniel Ott.
It's the time.
Now, we'll go back to our newsmaker line. Hello, you're talking to the Edge.
Hello.
Yes, this is CD.
Yes, that's Daniel.
This is Daniel Ott of the Edge Radio Broadcast.
How are you?
Oh, pretty good there. Now, do I refer to you as CD or Ms. Montana? Well, how are we going to go with this?
My name is actually Coral, so you could call me that, or you can call me CD, whichever.
Okay. Well, you've got that nice Australian sort of dialect there. Sounds pretty good.
Yeah.
you haven't tried out for the...
Yeah, it's a bit of a dead giveaway, my Australian accent, isn't it?
Yeah, you haven't tried out for the Geico commercial, have you?
No.
Okay. All right, well, I'll tell you what, Coral, welcome to the Edge broadcast, and thank you so much for coming on. And, you know, we've never really covered a topic like we're going to be talking to you tonight regarding something that you are convinced has happened to you, and why don't we just get right into it and tell us a little bit about yourself and then how you came to believe that you may in fact be, that famous Indian.
Yes. Well, obviously I was born and raised in Australia. I'm 57 years old now. I was about 52 when I first sort of got led into learning what I know. Growing up, I was never interested in psychic things. They weren't really talked about very much. Native American Indians, it's not a subject that gets talked about a lot in Australia, but I always loved Sitting Bull. He was my hero growing up, and I just loved watching Indian shows. But it all really came to a head probably in around about 2001. I found out that I could actually physically talk to my spirit guide, Mary Ann, and I now know that I've been talking with Mary Ann all of my life, but I always thought that it was just myself talking to myself, if that makes sense.
Yeah.
And it wasn't until I started reading a lot about reincarnation, which is a subject I've always been interested in, and I got led into that path of finding out about Mary Ann. The thing that first led me into finding out about Crazy Horse was one day I was out with one of my friends and I got drawn into a little store and I brought Bury My Heart at Wounded Knee. I had no intentions of buying it. And I went home and started reading it and it just, all of a sudden all these memories started flashing back to me and I thought, whoa, you know, this is just unbelievable. And Mary Ann kept telling me to read the book. And then she started, I started hearing Crazy Horse in my head and I didn't know why because I really hadn't taken any notice of Crazy Horse. I'd always only just taken notice of Sitting Bull. But obviously I read about him in this book called, you know, Bury My Heart at Wounded Knee. Mm-hmm. And I said to Mary Ann, was I crazy horse? And she said, well, do you think you were? And I said, no. And she goes, well, you probably weren't then. So that was okay. But I'd had a couple of regressions and I'd gone back into my Lakota life or Sioux life, and I'd seen myself as an Indian, getting on and off my horse and checking my horse. And it was strange because I asked myself what my name was before I came out of the regression, and the man said Jack. So I thought, well, it can't be an Indian if his name's Jack. So anyway, a few weeks after I'd brought the book, Marianne asked me to go onto the internet and look up Crazy Horse. And I said, well, there's not going to be anything about Crazy Horse on the internet. And of course I found a lot of things and ordered a couple of books, because by now I was getting intrigued with all of this and the fact that, you know, I was getting these strange feelings, and she kept bringing it up. And when I got the books and I started reading about Crazy Horse, some of the things I was reading reminded me of things I'd seen in my regressions. Mm-hmm. Even what he, you know, the colour of his skin was lighter, and it was a little lighter in the regressions I'd seen. And a little while later I found out that my spirit name is actually Jack, and so that was who I was referring to when I said my name was Jack. It just got to me so much that I knew I had to come to South Dakota and just see the place. I mean, I just felt I needed to go back to South Dakota by now. And I was still confused as to, well, was I Crazy Horse or was I not Crazy Horse? And I kept thinking, no, I couldn't have been. He was a famous Indian. I'd always been one of these people that thought, oh, anyone that thinks that they were someone famous is probably just making it up, because everybody wants to be somebody who was famous. Mm. But, of course, I didn't know anything about him until I started reading. But the more famous he became when I was reading, the less I really believed that was who I could have been. But before I came back to South Dakota in April 2003, Marianne said to me one day, I said to her, no one seems to know where Crazy Horse is buried, you know. It'd be great if I could find out. And she said to me, you'll know where you're buried. We'll show you where you're buried. And I said, well, how? And she said, because we know where you're buried and we're going to show you. So my son came over with me at the end of April 2003, and we spent a month over here. My first real emotional experience was when I went up to see Sitting Bull, see his grave. And I was so happy to actually be up there and to see his grave. And I said to my son, this is amazing. I'm up at Sitting Bull's grave. And as I started walking towards it, I just became totally hysterical and just started sobbing and sobbing and sobbing. And I just couldn't control myself. And I wasn't sure why. That particular day, I felt a very hard hand on my shoulder. I knew it was Sitting Bull, and I did talk to him in spirit. By then I was starting to realise that I was talking to more people than just Marianne, that there were other spirits around me talking to me, and I could actually communicate with them. During that trip over, I did find my grave in Nebraska. It was amazing the way the spirits led my son and I to it. And there's not a doubt in my mind that that is where Crazy Horse is buried. We found pieces, little pieces of red blanket that were under the rocks and that had made their way up to the top under the rocks, and there's blood stains on them. I had